Hello everyone, I am Nagavelli Prasad, working in TSRR's Center of Excellence, Karimnagar. Today I am going to explain you an interesting topic, Human Excretory System. So in this lecture I am going to give you a brief information on the structures, the different organs present in the human excretory system which helps in the excretion process. Let us see what are the organs present in the human excretory system. So there are four organs present in the human excretory system, which are a pair of kidneys and a pair of ureters and a single urinary bladder and a single urethra. If we start from the kidneys are reddish brown bean shaped organs, reddish brown and bean shaped organs located in the abdomen cavity and attached to the dorsal wall, not in the middle, dorsal wall, either side of vertebral column. They are attached to the dorsal wall located either side of vertebral column, and their exact location is, as vertebral column has several vertebrae, right? So the last thoracic vertebrae, which is T12, from the T12, after thoracic last vertebrae, lumbar vertebrae will start, right? L1 and lumbar 2 and lumbar 3. So between T12, last thoracic vertebrae, and third lumbar vertebrae, between the kidneys are located. So now I will show you. So this is the dorsal wall, that side wall, right? Attached either side of a vertebral column. Now you can see this is the vertebral column. And their location exactly between the T12 and L3. T12, last thoracic vertebra, and lumbar third. And the interesting thing in human beings is, right kidney slightly lower than the left kidney. Why? Because the upper abdomen cavity mostly comprises with liver. Liver is located upper abdomen cavity. Due to presence of liver, it occupies most area, so that the right kidney is slightly lower than the left kidney, right? And then the outer surface is looks like convex, and the inner surface has a notch. So the notch is called as hilum. So here there is a notch like structure is known as hilum, and this is convex like surface you are seeing, right? And each kidney is surrounded by tough fibrous capsule known as renal capsule, which protect the softer tissue, because the kidney is made up of nephrons, and that all a soft tissue, it should be protected. That is called as renal capsule. Then coming to the internal structure of the kidney, it is very important. Internal structure of kidney, when we see, the outer region of kidney is known as cortex, the inner region of kidney known as medulla. So medulla has cone-shaped masses of tissues. The cone-shaped masses of tissues present in the medulla known as renal pyramids. They are called as renal pyramids. Cone-shaped masses present in the medulla known as renal pyramids. So these are the renal pyramids. They are located in the medulla region, and each renal pyramid separated by projections of cortex. So this is the cortex region, this is the projection of cortex, right? So these are separated by the columns known as renal columns. So these are called as renal columns, are columns of Bettini. So columns of Bettini are renal columns which separates renal pyramids. So just we can see, this is the base of renal pyramid, right? The base of each pyramid originate at the border of cortex and medulla. This is cortex, and here medulla is starts, okay na? So this will be obviously border, right? So each pyramid originates from at the border of cortex and medulla, and terminates at a structure known as renal papilla. Each pyramid origination is where it is originating, at border of cortex and medulla. Clear? Then they terminate at a structure known as renal papilla. So renal papilla projects into complex structure known as calyces. Each singular calyx, remember, each renal papilla projects into complex structure known as calyx or plural calyces. And how the calyces are forming, you know, this region is known as pelvis. This region is known as pelvis. Pelvis is a cone shaped structure which has extensions. These are the extensions of pelvis. Okay. So each extension is formed as calyces. So the calyces is a place where renal pyramid terminates. Renal pyramid terminates at the renal papilla. Renal papilla connected to calyces. Calyces are the extensions of pelvis. So pelvis is a region where urine, after forming from the nephrons, from the collecting ducts, all the collecting ducts drains, collects the urine and send into the pelvis. Pelvis is a region which pumps the urine into the ureters in order to send to urinary bladder. So this region is known as pelvis. Clear? This is regarding internal structure of kidneys. Then coming to the ureters. We have a pair of ureters which are slender whitish tubes. These tubes emerge from the pelvis region. As I told you, pelvis is a region from where urine is sent out from the each kidney. Right? So the urine is urine travels or passes through the each ureters. That ureter send the urine into the urinary bladder. And the inner lining of each ureter is lined by transitional epithelium. So the transitional epithelium is present inside the wall of ureters. Then the next part of excretor system is urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is a storage sac of urine. After collecting the urine will be stored for some time. It is also in line with the transitional epithelium, and whose neck leads into urethra. So urethra has two sphincters, which urethra is guarded by the two sphincters. The internal sphincter is made up of smooth muscles, which is not under control, and external sphincter is made up of striated muscles. In females, this urethra opens near the vaginal orifice. In males, urethra travels along with the penis and opens outside at glans penis. This is regarding human excretory system. Thank you.